Hey guys, what's up? It's Caitlin. Welcome back to the channel, or welcome to the channel. Today I'm gonna be doing a get ready with me and just kind of a chatty video. I'm gonna talk to you guys about my life, my mental health, some things that most people probably don't care about, but I know there are a handful of you that have been wanting me to kind of talk about my life and my situation and my mental health and all that kind of thing. So I finally feel like I can talk about it a little bit more because this year has been really hard, and it's been hard to talk about, as I feel like many people watching this can probably relate to that. So yeah, that's what we're gonna be doing today. I'm not gonna talk too much about what I'm putting on my face. Everything will be in the description box, so check it out. So, new background, it's not ideal. I'm behind a window, which kind of is nice because I'm backlit. Normally, I am on the wall over there and it's just a gray wall. But recently, my parents got new flooring, so I rearranged my room and I really love it so much. It's just so much more clean. I just don't miss the carpet at all. We had carpet in our bedrooms and I just don't miss it at all, and it's so nice. So I'm trying to figure out like what background. I don't hate this as much as I thought I would, but it is kind of awkward. It's not ideal, but you know what, the background I had before wasn't ideal either, so whatever. So I just feel like I haven't like talked to you guys. If you follow me on Instagram, I tend to like go on rants and talk about my life a little bit more over there, so definitely follow me. Yeah, I feel like on here it's been a while. When's the last time I posted a get ready with me? Let me look. I honestly don't know. I don't know how long. It's been several months, I think. But gosh, you guys, my skin's so dry. I don't even know where to start. I don't even know where to start, honestly. Well, I guess I'll start at the beginning. Let's start at the beginning of the year. So as you guys know, or most of you know, I graduated in December and I got my bachelor's in graphic design. And, you know, I was super burnt out. At the end of my semester in December, I was so burnt out from all the work that I had been doing. Staying up so late and just presentations and final presentations and getting everything together. I mean, it was so intense. So once I graduated, I took a couple of months off and I was just living my best life. I was doing really good. I was just chilling. I'm like, I'm in no rush. I can take a little bit of time off. And the city that I was living in and where, you know, I went to school, I had a roommate at my apartment there. My lease wasn't up till May. So I, you know, in February and January, whatever, I was like, I have time to figure out a job position. Also, when I was in school, I worked as an intern graphic designer in the communications department. And they, right as I graduated, they were hiring a graphic designer. And I'm like, I have a shoe in, like, you know what I mean? And my boss was kind of hinting like, you might have this job. I mean, you know, so I wasn't worried about it. I was feeling optimistic. And then I also, in like February, I had applied to Hush Puppies. If you guys aren't familiar with Hush Puppies, they are a big like shoe brand. They were hiring a production artist, so I actually applied to that and I had 3 interviews. I know I've talked to you guys about this before, but I'm setting the scene. I was so confident in those interviews. Like, I don't even know who that person was. Like, I've just never been that. I'm a really shy, very intimidated by other people. I'm a shy person. So when I had those interviews, I freaking nailed them. I did so good, and I was very shocked to find out I did not get the job. I feel like that event kind of like triggered all of the BS that was to come in 2020, for me anyway. Oh, by the way, I am using the Nabla Cosmetics palette. I've been wanting to do an indie brand on them, but I've just been lazy, okay? Okay, I'll admit it. It's just like, I'm home all the time. Why am I gonna put makeup on when I'm just laying in my bed all day, you know? Okay, anyway, I'm getting distracted. So I didn't get the job. And I felt defeated. I felt like a loser. I feel like that was a lesson to, like, you know, you just never know what an employer is thinking, and to not put all of your apples in one basket. And I guess I didn't, because I had the other position at the school that I definitely thought I was a good contender for. I was excited about that job, but I was more upset that it kind of, not getting that job screwed up my timeline, because at the beginning of the year, y'all, I was like, this is my year. Okay, I say that every year, but like, I really felt it. I really felt it this year. I was like, you know, Miguel and I, my boyfriend and I, are finally gonna get an apartment together. We literally had picked out an apartment that we're like, yes, we love this. So in my head, I'm like, we're gonna get engaged this year, and like all of these things are gonna happen, and I'm so excited about it. Because I didn't get the job, I was worried I wasn't gonna be able to find work before my lease was up in the city that I was living in. And I was like, this is gonna suck if I'm gonna have to move all of my stuff back to my parents' house and then eventually have to move it all the way back to the city. Because I'd like to live in the city where my apartment was, where I was going to school, and blah blah blah. And so I was like, this is gonna really suck, and I can't, like, if I didn't get a job, I can't afford to just get an apartment, and like I have no income, so that would be stupid. So then that was like in February, and then March happened and all of our lives collectively kind of went to like, let's be honest. I'm very much a homebody and all of that, so I mean, I wasn't too affected by it as far as like, I don't go out and do a lot of things, to be really honest with you. I definitely ended up like, you know, missing my friends and that kind of thing, because I really didn't see anybody, but I just like video chatted with people, and it didn't feel too different to me. All the way through like April, I was just vibing. I'm like, oh, it sucks because like the economy was crap. No one was really hiring, you know, because like it's just uncertain times, you know, so I wasn't able to get a job. Also, because of Corona, the position at the school was kind of like nixed, and so that wasn't an option for me either. And so I pretty much just accepted at that point, I'm gonna have to move back to my parents' house. And there's nothing wrong with that, but it definitely did make me feel like a loser and all of that. And it's just such a pain to have to like pack up your life, move it someplace, knowing that eventually you want to move it back. It's just annoying, but whatever. It's not the worst thing. A lot of people don't even have a place to go back to, so I'm very fortunate in that sense. But I'm just telling you guys how it is. And just because another situation might be worse doesn't mean that my situation doesn't suck, you know? Whenever I'm like complaining about stuff, I'm never trying to compare my life to anybody else's situation ever. I hope you guys know that. But anyway, I know I'm very fortunate. All right, May happens. I'm at my apartment. I went to my apartment a couple of times, packed my stuff up, and, you know, just prepare. And then May 23rd. Ooh, all right. So May 23rd happened, and that was Memorial Weekend, right? It was the official day I was moving all of my stuff back. Well, actually, let me backtrack to May 22nd. I was at my apartment with Miguel packing the last of my stuff up. I get a call from my mom, and she's like, Jordan was my 14-year-old dog that stayed at my parents' house while I went to school. I was also planning on taking her with me. You know, when I moved into the apartment that Miguel and I picked out, I had planned for Jordan to come with me. I was looking at apartments on the first floor so she didn't have to use any stairs. Like, she was a part of the plan, right? So May 22nd, my mom calls me and she's like, Jordan is not doing well. And I know her health had been kind of slowly going down, but it very rapidly went down. So I was like, okay, I am gonna pack up as much as I can, and then I'm coming home. Miguel took me home, and then the next day, the 23rd, is when my dad's friend, and Miguel took a trailer to go take all the rest of the stuff from my apartment. And originally, I was a part of that plan. I was supposed to be helping them, but I knew I had to be with Jordan. And after spending that day with her, my mom and I were like, we have to put her down. Like, it's just unfair at this point. Yeah, and I can't talk about it too much still, just because it's a good thing I have tissues available. This is why I couldn't make a video for so long, you guys, because I miss her. And so we had to put her down, and it was very painful. And I know that she lived a very good life, and but it still hurts. Someone has never had an animal that like was a part of their family. Like, they don't understand, you know, oh, it's just a dog, it's just a cat or whatever. But like, Jordan was my baby. She was a part of my family. My parents loved her. Miguel, my boyfriend, loved her. Like, she was our family. So I think it was just like this domino effect of like accepting that things were not gonna go the way I had planned this year, you know? Like, it was first, okay, I'm not getting that job, and then I'm not getting the apartment, and I'm moving back home now, and now my dog is gone, and all of the plans that I had just kind of went to trash. And it just, again, I know I'm very fortunate. My dog lived a very long and great life, but it's still hurts. For the next, you know, month or so, it was just me healing. It was just me, you know, trying to figure out my stuff. I'm still jobless. I now live at my parents' home out of boxes. I don't have my best friend anymore. You know, I mean, she was literally by my side at all times. Whenever I was home, I mean, she was attached to me at the hip. So it was just it was weird being in the house without her. So yeah, I was just grieving for a while and trying to figure out how my, you know, and just like trying to accept all the things that were changing and not going how I planned. And I think for a lot of people, the quarantine really taught us a lot of different lessons. I think it slowed us all down. It definitely slowed me down. And it also made me realize that you literally never know what is going to happen. You can plan as much as you want, but you have to kind of be content. Even though it's really hard, you have to kind of be content in the fact that you never know what is going to happen. Pre-quarantine, I feel like we all like felt like we had control, but we never really have control. We never do. We never know what's going to happen. And I think that's really hard to accept. And I don't necessarily know if I have accepted it yet, but it made me think about it a little bit more. And so I feel like for a lot of the year, I've just like been like dealing with a lot of depression and a lot of anxiety. I feel like this has probably been one of the worst times in my life for depression and anxiety, like honestly. And I feel like it's always so important to talk about, because I think so many people online just always present their best life and like they don't talk about a lot of the things. Because I get it, because when you're an influencer, I feel like you always get this criticism that you're just put to such high standards. You know, it's like, oh, you have such a great life, what are you complaining for? And you get so much hate. So I totally understand the people that just like don't talk about their struggles, because all they're matched with is people that they don't know criticizing them and that kind of thing. And I know that I get that, but also I'm not a huge influencer, so who knows, my views on that might change if I ever got more followers or whatever. But I do think it's important, just because the more we talk about it with our family and our friends and the influencers that we follow, the more we realize that a lot of the people that we know are going through the same, you know, struggles and thoughts and that kind of thing. Girl, I gotta start putting on some makeup. My goodness, I have 2 eyeshadow shades on right now. That's it. The following months, you know, after my dog passed away, it was, like I said, it was grieving, but it was also still a combination of I need to find a job. And I was really struggling with just feeling like a total loser, and like just the expectations of others and society in general was just really, really difficult to navigate for me. I mean, I just like didn't know how to handle this feeling, because for so long, for my entire life, my only goal was school. I had an end goal. I had, you know, this purpose. Ever you get comfortable in life, that's when things change. And that's exactly what happened to me. And it's like I graduated, and now what is my goal? What is my purpose? What am I doing? I don't know. I have no idea. And I've just gone through so many things of like, is YouTube something that I want to pursue? Is TikTok something I want to pursue? But I also need to look for a real life job, whatever that even means. And like, it's just so confusing. And I just have been thinking so much lately about, you know, corporate America and what is standard in our society. And I just feel like I think there's a different way of living. And I've just been thinking so much about like the American dream. And a lot of people paints this picture of there's one way to success. There's only one, and it's get a good education, get a 9-to-5 salary position, work till you're 60, retire. And it's also in the meantime, find somebody, get married, have children. That is success to so many people. And there's nothing wrong with that. If that makes you happy, then that's beautiful. And that's what you should do. In time and time again, there has been so many people that criticize others for not wanting that standard career or lifestyle or whatever it may be. And I have experienced it. Pretty much every single person I have met has experienced it in some way or another. And there's just so much judgment out there, and I just like don't understand it. I've got to be honest, I'm so tired of the question when I first meet somebody. I'm so tired of the question, what do you do? What is your career? As if that's the one defining thing that defines my worth as a human being. I'm literally so tired of it. And I know it's a harmless question, and I don't get ever mad at the person that's asking me it, because it's a very standard question. But like, what if that wasn't the standard question? What if the standard question was, what makes you happy? I don't know. Like, what a interesting question to like understand somebody that you just met of like, that was the standard question. That is such a better question. I don't know. Like, I don't know if it's an American thing. I think it might be. I think it's an American thing where it's like, we just put so much worth. And I literally went on a whole Instagram rant about this. And it's like, I feel like whenever somebody asks me that question, whatever my answer is, as far as what do I do for work, whatever answer I give them is now how they're going to value me as a person. And I know that's not always true, but there are people out there that think like that. I've had to defend myself as a designer, as an artist, so many times of just like, well, like, what kind of like money could you make with like being an artist? I don't know, Susan. Look around you. Look in your home. Look on your TV. Everything is art. Everything is design. I'm so tired of it. I'm getting like angry right now. But it's like I've had to defend myself so many times. And I've heard other people, like people that work in the food industry, if you work at fast food, if you work at a restaurant, I have heard people judging other people of like, well, don't you want more for your life? I'm sorry. Who are you? Everyone has their definition of success and happiness, and the moment it becomes a problem is when you start judging other people if they have a different definition. I don't know. I just think like, I want you guys to know that I value you so much more than your job. And like, if your career is everything to you, that's fantastic. Whenever I think of this, I think of Katy Perry's song, Chained to the Rhythm. And that's how I feel. I feel like we're all just like chained to the American conveyor belt dream. And like, we can't leave it. Like, we're chained. We can't leave because of our student loans and like our, you know, society telling us that that's how we should live because that's the best way to live. And you know, the Americans, we know everything and blah, blah, blah. And I'm just like, you know what? Maybe we don't. You know, maybe there is a different way of looking, you know, and I don't know. I could keep going on, you guys. And I probably no one's watching this except Belle. Hi, Belle. That's just what's been like on my mind. I've been thinking so much about all of those things. And I feel like the way that I think and the way I perceive the world from the beginning of this or the end of last year to now is a different person. It is a different human being. Going off of like the Black Lives Matter movement and all of that, and I've had to check myself with a lot of my privileges. Just because I have lived one life doesn't mean that's everyone's experience. And I think once you realize that, you're like, whoa, like I want to learn more and I want to understand other people's perspectives and become a more compassionate and empathetic human being. This year, y'all, it's like part of there. I think there's a lot of good things that have come out of 2020, a lot of hard conversations and a lot of looking inward at, you know, yourself and whatever. But there's been a lot of really crappy things that have happened this year. But anyway, going back to my life and kind of where I'm at, I know I just went on like a huge tangent. My teachers have been awesome at like sending me jobs and they've kept in touch with me and they're just really good people. So my one professor had emailed me this one studio was looking for someone, and so I got in contact with them and all of that. And so I started an internship with them. I was working about 20 hours a week for like, I don't know, a month or something like that. And they just now recently offered me not a salaried position, but a full-time contract position for 6 months. And then the possibility of it turning into a salary position at the end of that 6 months. So we will see. I have really enjoyed working for this company, and the projects and the people seem really great. Like, I'm really excited about it. It's just crazy to see that like so much of my depression, and I'm still there, y'all. I'm still struggling, but I feel like once I got this internship, it at least got me out of bed, and it at least like gave me like a focus. And it also makes me question, like, it's crazy how much value and how much I look at myself when I'm not employed. And it goes back to that mindset of like, why do I feel this way? Sorry, my camera just died and then I decided to go do my eyebrows while I was gone. I don't remember exactly what I was saying. For me, I don't feel like my purpose is working. And I think to some people that is like, oh, you must be really lazy and whatever. No, I know how to work very hard, but it just made me look, it just kind of like made me think about like, why did I feel that way and that kind of thing. Basically what I'm saying is, I value you guys so much more than what you do for your work, and I challenge each and every one of you to like think of a couple of other questions to ask people when you first meet them that is not what work do you do. I think it's interesting. So just like think to yourself, you know, and there's nothing wrong with asking that question. I think it could be better. I think we could do better. So that's my point. I would really love to hear your guys's like perspective and what you think of this. And I know that these topics, some people will be like, you're insane, you know, but other people might really resonate with what I'm saying. When I went on my Instagram rant and I was talking about the same things, I actually got like a handful of people that messaged me and were like, yes, I relate to that and I agree with that. And I was like, oh, for a second I thought I was talking crazy and like no one was gonna get it. But I feel like there are people out there that resonate with that. And I just feel like we need to just talk about it more. We need to talk about our standards and maybe changing them, you know? In the comments though, I would love it if you guys kind of left, I don't know, something about society that you don't like and how you wish it was different, because I would love to hear like different perspectives on that. And I feel like hearing from other people, it will kind of check ourselves and understand how like maybe there's a different way to like approach it or something like that. I don't know. I'm just always open to like hearing other people's like experiences and being a little bit more sympathetic to that. As far as like my mental state right now, there's not a day that goes by that I don't still have, you know, negative, really mean thoughts to myself. I think that we all need to be a little bit nicer to ourselves, especially right now. Things are just so uncertain, but yeah, I'm struggling, you guys. I am, but I mean, I can at least talk about some of the things now. There was a time, you know, maybe like a month after my dog had died, where I tried to film like a get ready with me, and like I just couldn't do it. You know, I just couldn't even talk about it, and I at least feel a little bit better now. But it's still a daily struggle for me. I'm not gonna lie. I'm a little nervous how like this is, you know, this job is gonna affect my, you know, YouTube outlet, because I feel like YouTube and like my TikTok videos like take a lot of creativity. And so if I'm spending all day being creative with other things, it might be like hard for me to do this on the side. So I don't know, we will see. It might be fine, it might not. I mean, I really don't know at this point. Like I feel so confused. Like I don't know what I want, you know, and it just kind of sucks. It's kind of annoying, but I've always kind of felt like I wanted to be my own boss. Like I wanted to start a business. But I just feel like right now it's just not happening, and maybe it's like kind of a side thing or whatever. I don't even know. I don't even know what I'm saying right now. I just, at this point, I just feel really confused, and I think that has been a common reoccurring theme for me after I graduated. I just don't, like, I don't have an end goal anymore. And I think that's like the point of life. I don't know. I feel like as humans, we're always like looking, like we can't wait to get to the next end goal, and maybe that's the point of like this lesson of like I need to start living in the moment and not for the end point. So what lip product do I want to wear today? I grabbed a couple of Jogia Cosmetics glosses. I really love these glosses, and they did send them to me, but I'm gonna go with this one. This one is in Kissable. I don't know if I love that. It's a little bit more pink than I wanted, but I don't hate it. For the first time yesterday, and I want to say my whole life, but I could be wrong, I parted my hair in the middle. I don't know. Like, at first I'm like, ew, but then like once I wear it a little bit, it looks a little bit better. I don't know. Whatever. I'm gonna leave it like that. Honestly, I'm probably gonna go take this makeup off pretty soon anyway. So, I think that was everything I had to cover. I would love to hear about how you guys have been doing, how this year has kind of affected you. And yeah, let me know about the society thing of like, what about society do you wish you could change? For me, I just wish people were more open to other lifestyles and a little bit more compassionate to other lifestyles, you know. I just think that we really need to shake that there's one, you know, that there's only one way to success and happiness, because it's simply just not true. So I hope you guys enjoyed. I feel like, thank you to the like two people that watched this whole video. I appreciate it. I hope you guys are doing well. And give me some video suggestions too, girl, because like I don't even know what to do. But anyway, I love you guys so much, and I will talk to you hopefully soon. Bye.